Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about one of the important that is essential for you, and it is important for exam purpose also. And here we are going to discuss about neurohumoral transmission in CNS. So this is important for you. Again, for exam purpose, again, you have to know about this. So first of all, I want to share my screen. This is. So we will discuss about neurohumoral transmission in the CNS. And okay. You can start now. This one. Neurotransmitters in CNS. You have to know the classification of neurotransmitter in CNS. And about that, you have to know 2-3 points regarding that neurotransmitter. So do you know in CNS, two types of neurotransmitter is present. One is inhibitory, another one is excitatory neurotransmitter. And in classification, we'll get idea regarding this. So second slide, that is you can classify neurotransmitter. Some neurotransmitter is excitatory nature and some inhibitory and some both. Like example, glutamate, aspartate, nitric oxide are excitatory neurotransmitter, and inhibitory neurotransmitter like glycine, GABA, serotonin, dopamine, and both acetylcholine and norepinephrine. These things you have to remember, what are the excitatory, what are inhibitory, and both type of neurotransmitter present in CNS. This chart is very, very important. In exam, you may get one more question like write any two inhibitory neurotransmitter present in CNS. Then you have to write. And in your syllabus, they have asked for GABA, they have asked for GABA, glutamate, glycine, serotonin, and dopamine. These shortly you have to know what are this type of neurotransmitter. Again, you can classify neurotransmitter based on chemical nature, and you can know the neurotransmitter like small molecules means some biogenic amines. From here you can get idea serotonin, dopamine are the biogenic amine, and glutamate, GABA, glycine are the amino acid. And then these things you have to know. This chart is important for MCQs. Like they may ask like which of the following neurotransmitters are biogenic amines. Option A is serotonin, option B is GABA, option C is substance P, and option D is none of the above. Then you have to select a correct one, that is serotonin. Next, you have to know one by one, that is GABA. And you have to know the full form of GABA, that is GABA, gamma aminobutyric acid. And already you have idea regarding GABA receptor. Benzodiazepine and barbiturates are binds with the GABA receptor, allosteric site of the GABA receptor. So you have idea regarding this GABA. And here you have to know whether GABA is inhibitory or excitatory neurotransmitter. From classification, you have idea that GABA is an inhibitory neurotransmitter present in brain. And this thing, absence of GABA, benzodiazepine have no effects on GABA A. Next, you have to know this is the GABA receptor, and you know in GABA 3 subunits is present alpha, beta and gamma, and here benzodiazepine binding site is there, GABA binding site, GABA antagonist binding site, barbiturate binding site, GABA agonist binding site, all have different binding sites. That's why it is also known as GABA, benzodiazepine and barbiturate binds to the allosteric site of the GABA. Allosteric means it is not binds with the main site, active site, but it is binds with the other site present in that receptor. Next, you have to know about glutamate. From drug classification, you know glutamate is one of the excitatory neurotransmitter. So you have to know about this, and you can understand the mechanism of action. Okay. Next, you have to know about dopamine. Dopamine is another neurotransmitter, and it is inhibitory in nature. And different types of dopamine is there, like mainly five types of dopamine is present. You can see here D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, means D2 to D5. And here is specific side of side where this dopamine acts. Means D1 is present, D2 location, D1 location, D2, D3, D4, D5. But D2 location is very, very important. This D2 type of dopamine present in striatum, and this D2, due to the excitation or inhibition of D2 receptors, it affects on behavior, voluntary movement, prolactin release. You have to remember these points. This D2 receptor is very, very important. Do you know about neurohumoral disease? That is Parkinson's and Alzheimer. What is the main reason of Parkinson's? In Parkinson's, what happened? Dopamine level is decreased and acetylcholine level is increased. So in that Parkinson's, for the treatment of Parkinson's, dopamine facilitator is used for enhance the dopamine activity. So that dopamine facilitators binds with the D2 type of receptors. So again, you have to know this various subtypes of dopamine is D1, D2, D3, D4, D5. Here main site of action is there. You have to remember the site of action for MCQs. So D1 is present in corpus luteum, D2 is present in substantia nigra, D3 is present in limbic system, D4 is present in midbrain, and D5 is present in hippocampus, hypothalamus. So this is important. And dopamine synthesis, if you want to remember this, dopamine synthesis, already you have idea regarding adrenaline synthesis or noradrenaline synthesis. Same steps, but here only three steps is there. Dopamine precursor, you have to remember the dopamine precursor is tyrosine. In MCQs, you may get questions like, what is the precursor of dopamine? That is tyrosine amino acid. That means dopamine is formed from tyrosine. From tyrosine, L-DOPA is formed with the help of tyrosine hydroxylase. And from L-DOPA, dopamine is formed with the help of DOPA decarboxylase. So this dopamine is stored in vesicles. And from vesicle, this neurotransmitter is released into synaptic cleft and then binds with the receptor present in postsynaptic nerve ending. So you can remember this. After that, another neurotransmitter, that is serotonin. And you know serotonin is another inhibitory neurotransmitter, and it is also a biogenic amine. So you can, in next slide, you can see, these are the different subtypes of serotonin, like dopamine, four subtypes is there. And in dopamine, five subtypes is there. 5-HT receptor. 5-HT means 5-hydroxytryptamine, also known as serotonin. And 5-HT1 is 5-HT2, 5-HT3, 5-HT4. And if you want to know the receptor types, do you know various types of receptor? There are mainly four types of receptor. First one is inotropic, ionotropic receptors, or channel, ion channel receptors. Second one is GPCR, G-protein coupled receptor. Third one is enzyme-linked receptor. Fourth one is nuclear receptor. So all serotonin have are GPCR type of receptor except 5-HT3. This is important for MCQs. Which of the following serotonin have serotonin subtypes is inotropic binds follows, or which of the following serotonin subtypes having inotropic type of receptors? You have to know that 5-HT3 only. And mechanism, if you want to mechanism of action, means all these 5-HT1 have inhibitory activity. That means this 5-HT1 type of receptor, means serotonin, when binds with the adenylate cyclase, then it reduces the action of adenylate cyclase, ultimately reduce the production of cyclic AMP. So ultimately it gives inhibitory action and decrease the activity of adenylate cyclase. And 5-HT2 have excitatory excitatory action. It acts through IP3 DAC pathway, and inotropic, it affects on ion channel sodium potassium, and excitatory again, you know, increase the adenylate cyclase activity. So again here the synthesis process is there. In dopamine, I have seen the dopamine precursor is tyrosine, but in serotonin, from the name itself, you can remember the precursor of serotonin, that is tryptophan, 5-hydroxytryptophan. That means this 5-hydroxytryptophan is found from tryptophan amino acid. You can remember this. So this is the basic selective agonist and antagonist. If you remember this chart, selective agonist and antagonist, in fifth unit, again, you have to know the pharmacology of drugs acting on central nervous system. There, Parkinson's, maybe you will get Parkinson's Alzheimer's disease. In that Parkinson's Alzheimer's disease, you will get this type of drugs. Again, another neurotransmitter, that is glycine. And you know, glycine is another inhibitory neurotransmitter. And this glycine binds with the glycine receptor, that is taurine and beta-alanine. And strychnine is only one drug which acts against glycine. This strychnine, you have to remember. And in mechanism of action, you can remember that glycine binds with the NMDA receptors, and inhibits the activity, as because it is a inhibitory neurotransmitter. Then that's all about this neurotransmitter in CNS, central nervous system. You have to remember the what are the neurotransmitter. That means mainly classification of neurotransmitter in the CNS. Then only three to four points regarding that neurotransmitter. In exam, you may get questions like what are the neurotransmitter present in CNS. It may be for 2 marks question. So in that, you have to explain the pharmacological classification of the neurotransmitter present in CNS. Again, you have to point out, you have to write only 1 to 2 points regarding all each receptor neurotransmitter present in CNS. So you can do like that. So I'm going to stop sharing here. Thank you so much again.